The LEXION 8900 at work in England and Scotland. We are on site with our cameras at two of the locations. The conditions during this season are less than optimal. The large amount of rain during August has significantly shortened the harvesting window. We are here in the north of England. The combine harvesters have been waiting around for almost 2 weeks. So far, they have only managed a few hours' work, not really a great basis for a demonstration. But actually, this is exactly what our customers care about. They want to know, how does the new LEXION 8900 fare in these difficult conditions? Conditions which are present in every harvest. We are on the way to the Armstrong family's farming business. The brothers, James, David, and Neil, already used a LEXION 8700 from the previous series during the harvest in 2019 as the replacement for a LEXION 780.
We are in Northumberland here. We are a fortnight behind. We've only combined 4 days at the last 14 due to heavy showers of rain and not getting enough CHA and not getting enough sunshine. So it's been a struggle.
Tough going again, yes.
It's industry we're in, no 2 years are the same. What was harvest 18, a dry one, 19, a good yield, high yields, 20 is different. As you say, no 2 years are the same, and the weather's a big factor. So on the good days, you can't cut enough.
We start at 11 o'clock on 31st of August in a large wheat field. The average grain moisture is 17 to 18%. At a yield level of 12.5 tons per hectare, we run throughputs of up to 120 tons per hour, and with just 11.9 liters of fuel per hectare. At the end, we harvested 478 tons. And with a fuel consumption of just 0.95 liters per ton of cereals and a throughput of 95 tons of cereals per hour, including the headlands in each field. We move to a different field of wheat the next day. Here, the grain moisture is around 16.5%. The yield here is 10.4 tons per hectare. By 5 p.m., we will have harvested 42 hectares of wheat there. In terms of crop priority, the Armstrong's farming enterprise, with 500 hectares, covers the largest area, followed by 200 hectares of winter oilseed rape, 130 hectares of vining peas, and 80 hectares of winter barley. Plowing is only used as part of cultivation armory, but mainly a min-till system has been adopted. A large amount of straw is baled with a quadrant 5300, which copes well following a 12.3 meter header. Some is used for the Aberdeen Angus suckler herd and the rest sold. We want to identify the losses and we take regular loss samples. With the aid of a small sieving machine, we separate out the grains from the samples to make the result more precise. The sieving machine makes it very quick and easy. This means we'd rather take a few more samples if in doubt. We want to run at a loss limit of 1% and optimize the performance. CMOS Automatic also works based on this loss limit and extracts the full potential from the LEXION 8900. We are really happy with the results. We've harvested the whole area with a fuel consumption of just 10.65 liters per hectare. It's already 6 p.m., but we're starting on two more fields. We harvest a further 27 hectares late into the evening. While doing so, we come to appreciate the LED lighting on the cutter bar and the machine. The lights on the sides of the cutter bar are particularly helpful when making a start on a new area. What did Neil Armstrong say at the start of our visit? On good days, you can't harvest enough. Next morning, product manager Adam Hayward and Neil Armstrong evaluate the telematics data. The different areas and wheat varieties give an excellent overall picture of the unique performance potential of the LEXION. Fuel consumptions between 9 and 12 liters per hectare clearly show how efficiently the APS SynFlow hybrid threshing unit works. The throughput curves are particularly compelling here. Even late into the evening, the throughput remains at a consistently high level. The LEXION has made optimum use of the short harvesting window. The performance at the Armstrong farm has been a great success. The experienced team made short work of loading the LEXION, and we drive further north to Scotland. We are on our way to the Hayes Farms business in Perthshire. Hay Farms works a total of 3,400 hectares of owned, leased, and managed fields within a 30-kilometer radius around the business. We are greeted by classic Scottish rain and start by unloading. On the next day, the LEXION waits to start work, and we have time to talk with the area sales manager, Russell Clark, from CLAAS UK. He has been looking after this area for many years and knows the situation and requirements of his customers intimately. Russell has organized the demo here.
Yeah, so it is. It's the middle part of Scotland. We have a very diverse area from the south to the north. We have some very big estates with a lot of demand for big combines. But with the short weather window we have to combine in, because the weather can be, let's call it, very mixed, we do have a small window to combine into to get the crop in the best condition. If we have a good demo, then the guy can actually see what we've got to offer. Today, obviously, we're at one of the farms that this particular farmer owns, and he will have different demands of this crop behind us, so we'll go and combine this crop maybe today or tomorrow. Some of it will be used for going away into his market. The next bit will be kept for, let's say, some of his seed production for the following year. So, you know, there's a very big demand depending on which crop he's in and which area he's in, which variety he cuts in as well. And he's looking for everything from this machine to give him what he's needing for his old business. So, yeah.
It's 12 o'clock. We start the demo on one of three planned areas of oats. Today, the 30 hectares of oats are the first job on the list. The panicles of the oats dry faster than the ears of wheat, but the bulky oat straw is still damp. The oats are sold to numerous mills in the area and end up on the breakfast table in the form of porridge. Naturally, we want to show what the LEXION can do here too. Therefore, we make loss measurements again, sieving the samples. The high straw proportion and straw moisture content shouldn't be underestimated. Compared with wheat, oats have a significantly lower hectoliter weight. This also makes it harder to get the grains out of the straw. Even though the conditions are not ideal, we harvest just under 40 tons per hour on average. With 13.74 liters of fuel per hectare, the LEXION 8900 is also amazingly efficient in chopping mode. It's already after 5 p.m. when we start on the first of three wheat fields. As well as the crop, the terrain also becomes more demanding now. The last two fields of the day are the hilliest.
So it's been rather difficult conditions here today. We had rain overnight. We managed to get a good wind and sun up during the day. The moisture is still pretty high. It's about 20-21% moisture for the wheat. The oats are actually down to 16% moisture. We're currently harvesting late in tonight. We're trying to secure next year's seed crop when the conditions are still dry and good. The weather in this part of Scotland has been very difficult this harvest. We've had the highest rainfall for the year in August of 142 millimetres, which is not ideal during harvest. We're currently running two 780s with 12 metre headers and one 770 hired. So we want to cut from three combines back to two, and we see the 45 foot or the 13.8 metre headers being a great possibility for the future, along with the 8,000 series combines to work with them. Business here in Scotland, we're farming an area of land round about the Perth area. There's about 3,400 hectares of cereals. So for us, harvest time is a very important time of year. Many companies sell large combine harvesters nowadays, but for us, we've remained with CLAAS due to the backup and support from the manufacturer and from our local support here in Scotland, which is absolutely vital for us to secure a harvest in good conditions.
We also check the quality of our wheat while we are at the grain store, as it is being delivered truck by truck. The grain moisture content is now over 21%. Despite this, the LEXION maintains its consistently high performance at more than 60 tons per hour, harvesting the grain reliably. Here too, an average fuel consumption of just 12.44 liters per hectare confirms once more. The cost effectiveness of the LEXION is excellent, despite the difficult conditions.